Hey everyone, my name is Siddharth and I'm a medical intern here in India. Currently, I have given my USMLE Step 1 exam and I have passed it. And you are watching the question solving series, and this is the gastroenterology section. So let's begin with this question. Which of the following is most likely responsible for the development of gallstones in this patient? Okay, so they've already told us that the patient has developed gallstones. And so let's try to figure out what is the cause for it. A 64-year-old man comes to the office due to acute onset right upper quadrant pain and nausea, vomiting. Patient has had an extensive small bowel resection due to bowel ischemia a year ago and is receiving total parenteral nutrition since then. TPN is when the nutrition is directly given to the patient by a central line or by peripheral veins. His other medical problems include atrial fibrillation and hypertension. Examination shows right upper quadrant tenderness on deep palpation. Initial lab shows moderate leukocytosis with normal hepatic enzymes. So LFTs are normal. Abdominal ultrasound reveals gallstones and edema. Okay. Review of prior record indicates that he had no gallstones before. Okay. So the reason that I'm seeing here is that since the patient has been receiving total parenteral nutrition, there has been absence of enteral passage of fats and amino acids, which trigger the release of cholecystokinin, and this is responsible for the contraction of gallbladder. Since this is absent in cases of TPN, it leads to stasis of bile. And stasis of bile is a major risk factor for formation of gallstones. So yeah, this is a very simple concept for the USMLE Step 1 exam. And you can expect such questions even on the test day. So the option here is A, which is decreased CCK release due to lack of enteral stimulation. That's all.